Well, welcome back. Today we're going to be doing something probably controversial amongst Toll fans. I'm going to be trying to play some of Passion Play, a couple of excerpts. I won't get through it perfectly because it's very difficult material, but we're going to give it a go. Passion Play stirs controversy, I think, in that it's same as green olives would in a food. People either love it or hate it. There's usually not a lot of in between. You're not wrong if you don't like green olives, you know. It's just your taste, right? Either you like the taste or you don't. So when it comes to music, the same thing applies. So I don't think there's a right or a wrong in music. There's you know, we can say that some things require virtuosity, a virtuoso to play, and we can recognize that, but as far as the music and the notes and the harmonic structure of the thing, it's what pleases your ear and your individual taste. So I'm not going to say that, you know, this is a great album or a bad album because it's a personal judgment. But it happens to be my favorite Toll album. When I go back and when I listen to things, I like to listen to a lot of the records, particularly from this era. But this is the one I come back to the most, actually. As you probably know, the critics totally trashed it when it first came out. And I will admit to being very disappointed when I heard it the first time. I loved Aqualung and I loved Thick as a Brick. So melodic, particularly Thick as a Brick. All those melodic themes, the poetry is just amazing. And then came along Passion Play, and I was so excited to hear it. And I opened it up, and I put it on the turntable, and I played it. This was when I was probably 17, I guess. Yeah, 17. And man, I was just really disappointed. I didn't like it. And I thought, wow, you know, just very, very much a sense of disappointment. And then I listened to it again, and I listened to it again, and I listened to it again. And it, for me, it turned out being sort of like a Coen's brother movie, Coen brothers, one of their movies, like The Big Lebowski or Raising Arizona or whatever. Oh, Brother, Where Art Thou? It's you know, you think, well, it's okay the first time, and then you watch it three or four more times, and you find yourself laughing harder and harder as you get more familiar with the material. So that's what Passion Play did for me. I think the critics maybe didn't listen to it five times or six times or seven times or eight times. They listened to it once, and I think they probably had the same reaction that I did. Wow, this is different from Thick as a Brick. There's a lot more dissonance here. It seems to be more disjointed. The story makes no sense at all. And that, you know, and there's the soprano sax, which surprised me at first. I thought, well, gosh, where's the flute? You know, I like the flute. So there were a lot of things different about this album, and I'm going to kind of talk about a few of the things from a music theory standpoint, so you could probably skip over this if this doesn't interest you. In music theory, the first thing that we learn is they teach are some of the rules. At least this was when I was back in the 70s when I was studying music theory. There were certain rules that you followed to compose music, to make pleasing music, so to speak. And one of the things is you avoided dissonance to a large degree. So dissonance means it's two notes that don't sound good together. All right, so probably the most dissonant thing is a flatted second interval. So, yeah, that doesn't sound good together, does it? And then the second most dissonant interval is a flatted fifth. So that's what a flatted fifth sounds like. See, both of those are not very, they're not in harmony with each other. So we were taught to avoid those intervals. So anyway, you know, and there were certain chords that just were supposed to follow, you know, so if you were in the key of, let's say, A, and you played a B minor chord, that would naturally go to like the fifth chord, the E chord, maybe before coming back to A. But we were definitely supposed to keep away from that flatted fifth. So a flatted fifth would be like playing a C and then going to an F sharp. Because that it just had an ominous feeling to it, or C minor to that F sharp major. So we were kind of told to avoid those intervals because they're spooky. So if you take a song like Black Sabbath, the song off Black Sabbath's first album, it's all built around that flatted fifth interval. That's pretty much the whole song is just going from that to the flatted fifth note, because it sounds ominous. So Ian Anderson on this album, he uses those intervals. Like before going into the Overseer Overture, you've got... So you've got both a flatted fifth, and you've got the flatted second interval. So those are very dissonant, right? So this album's about the afterlife and heaven and hell, right? So in the sections on hell, maybe in the devil, you want to sound spooky. So he's using that effect there. So he uses that flat fifth interval like in the section here. I'm all for leaving and that being done. I put in a request to take up my turn in that forsaken paradise. So he's gone from the B minor to the F chord, which is the flatted fifth interval, to make it sound sort of spooky. So he's using that to great effect there. So that's part of the sophistication, I think, of this composition. The other thing is that I think that the main refrain of this is probably one of the most beautiful pieces of music he's ever written. And it, once again, it uses sort of a structure, I think I would call it more of like a hymnal, where the chords are moving, the harmonic structure under the melody is moving quite frequently, which is something you hear in hymns and compositions, classical compositions more. And to give you an example of that, the very opening. Do you still hear me? Do you still hear me even here? He's already challenging us with that melody because there's a note that's not in the scale. Do you still see me even here? Do you still hear me even? Do you still see me? Do you still see me even here? The silver cord lies on the ground. So he's already challenging our ear with that melody. And what I mean by that harmonic structure moving frequently under the melody. And so I'm sad, the young man said. Over the hill, not a wish away. So that movement is very original. I say very very sophisticated. So So that's another thing that I really like about the this composition, the frequent harmonic movement under the melody. Certainly this was Jethro Tull's displayed the most virtuosity of any of their records. The playing on this thing is incredibly difficult. The rhythms, the fast passages, gosh, it's just amazing. And I can't imagine playing this live in a concert. I just can't imagine it. I did hear Martin Barr talk about this album one time when they were saying, were you relieved to go or glad to go to a shorter song format after this album didn't do that well? And were you glad to go back to the shorter 3-4 minute song structure? And he said, yes, I was, because I could interact with the audience more that way. Before, I was having to concentrate so much on the music, counting the rhythms and the irregular measures, that I couldn't interact with the audience. So when we went back to a more simple song structure, I was able to interact and maybe entertain more. So he felt relieved, I think, having to get out from under this complex music. So I'm sure it was so difficult to play. Ian Anderson, of course, does not, I think maybe he was soured because of the critical response to this. And I don't think it went over big with audiences either, because there's just so much to it. It's so dense. And an audience that's there to hear Locomotive Breath and Aqualung is just not going to get into this piece. It has too much, too many soft passages, acoustic passages, and it just didn't translate well, I don't think. Maybe in a theater where everybody's sitting and it's a small, intimate environment and people are quiet and you can hear everything, I think maybe it would go over better in a situation like that. So he's not, doesn't sound like particularly fond of this record in retrospect. Martin Barr, on the other hand, feels like it was an important work. So anyhow, I think it's a very important work. And like I say, it's still the one that I come back to the most. All right, so here we go. I'm going to be trying to play the At the Foot of Our Stairs, and then I'm going to segue that into the Overseer Overture. All right, so wish me luck. Here we go.
We sleep by the ever-bright hole in the door. Eat in the corner, talk to the floor. Cheating the spiders who come to say please. Politely they bend at the knees. Well, I'll go to the foot of our stairs. Old gentlemen talk of when they were young, of ladies lost, of erring sons, lace-covered dandies revel with friends, pure as the truth, tied at both ends. Well, I'll go to the foot of our stairs. Scented cathedral, spire pointed down. We pray for souls in Kentish town. A delicate hush, the gods floating by, wishing us well high in the sky. God of ages, Lord of time, mine is the right to be wrong. Well, I'll go to the foot of our stairs. Jack Rabbit, mister, spawn a new breed of love. Three pilgrims, no bodies to feed. Show me a good man and I'll show you the door. The last hymn is sung and the devil cries more. Thank you. out my turn. In that forsaken paradise that calls itself hell, where no one has nothing and nothing is well. Meaningful, pick up that bed and rise up from your gloom, smiling. Give me your hate and do as the loving heathen do. Colors I've none, dark or light, red, white or blue. Cold is my touch, freezing. Summoned by name, I am the overseer of you. Overseer. Given this command to watch over a miserable sphere, fallen from grace, called on to bring sun or rain, occasional corn for my oversight grew. Seer. Fell with mine angels from a far better place, offering services for the saving of face. And now you're here, you may as well admire, on whom living has retired from the benign reconciliation. Legends were born surrounding mysterious lights, seen in the sky flashing. I just lit a fag and then took my leave. Of an eye, overseer. Passionate play, join round the maypole and dance. Primitive right wrongly, summoned by name, I am the overseer. Oh, you, overseer. Into the air, ever passion plays.